Thank you. Brothers and sisters, please rise and join in our opening song, King of Kings.
In the darkness we were waiting, without hope or without light, till from heaven you came running. There was mercy in your eyes to fulfill the law and prophets. To a virgin came the word, from the throne of endless glory to a cradle in the dirt. Praise the Father, praise the Son, praise the Spirit, three in one. God of glory, majesty, praise forever to the King of Kings. To reveal the kingdom coming and to reconcile the lost, to redeem the whole creation, you did not despise the cross. For even in your suffering, you saw to the other side, knowing this was our salvation. Jesus, for our sake you died. Praise the Father, praise the Son, Spirit, three in one. God of glory, majesty, praise forever to the King of Kings.
The morning that you rose, all of heaven held its breath, till the storm was moved for good, for the Lamb had conquered death.
And the dead rose from their tombs, and the angels stood in awe, for the souls of all who come to the Father are restored.
And the Church of Christ was born, and the Spirit lit the flame. Now this gospel truth of old shall not kneel, it shall not fade. By his blood and in his name, in his freedom I am free. For the love of Jesus Christ, who has resurrected me.
Praise the Father, praise the Son, praise the Spirit. To the King of Kings. Praise the Father, praise the Son, praise the Spirit, three in one. God of glory, majesty, praise forever to the King of Kings.
Praise forever to the King of Kings.
Worship the Lord. There we go. We come together to worship the Lord this day. We have so many reasons to return praise to the Lord. And the primary reason today, from which every other reason comes, is the resurrection, is the fact that our God is alive, and that in Jesus Christ, we too are promised eternal life. We too are promised resurrected bodies. So we live in that hope, even in our mortality. Brothers and sisters, let us come with joyful hearts. Let us acknowledge our sins and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. I confess to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and in what I have failed to do. Through my most grievous fault. Therefore I ask Blessed Mary, ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. On this day, through your only begotten Son, have conquered death and unlocked for us the path to eternity. Grant, we pray, that we who keep the solemnity of the Lord's resurrection may, through the renewal brought by your Spirit, rise up in the light of life. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
Amen. A reading from the Acts of the Apostles. Peter proceeded to speak and said, "You know what has happened all over Judea, beginning in Galilee after the baptism that John preached, how God anointed Jesus of Nazareth with the Holy Spirit and power. He went about doing good and healing all those oppressed by the devil, for God was with him. We are witnesses of all that he did, both in the country of the Jews and in Jerusalem. They put him to death by hanging him on a tree. This man raised on the third day and granted that he be visible, not to all the people, but to us, the witnesses chosen by God in advance, who ate and drank with him after he rose from the dead. He commissioned us to preach to the people and testify that he is the one appointed by God as judge of the living and the dead. To him all the prophets bear witness that everyone who believes in him will receive forgiveness of sins through his name. The word of the Lord.
This is the day that the Lord has made. Let us rejoice, let us rejoice, let us rejoice and be glad. This is the day that the Lord has made. Let us rejoice, let us rejoice, let us rejoice and be glad. Give thanks to the Lord, for he is good, for his mercy endures forever. Let the house of Israel say, his mercy endures forever. Let us rejoice, let us rejoice, let us rejoice and be glad. The right hand of the Lord has struck with power. The right hand of the Lord is exalted. I shall not die but live and declare the works of the Lord. Let us rejoice and be glad. The stone which the builders rejected has become the cornerstone. By the Lord has this been done. It is wonderful.
A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Colossians. Brothers and sisters, if then you were raised with Christ, seek what is above, where Christ is seated at the right hand of God. Think of what is above, not of what is on earth. For you have died, and your life is hidden with Christ in God. When Christ, your life, appears, then you too will appear with him in glory. The word of the Lord. Thanks be to God.
Christians to the Paschal victim, offer your thankful praises. A lamb the sheep redeems, Christ who only is sinless, reconcile sinners to the Father. Death and life have contended in that combat stupendous. The Prince of Life who died reigns immortal. Speak, Mary, declaring what you saw wayfaring. The tomb of Christ who is living, the glory of Jesus' resurrection. Bright angels attesting, the shroud and napkin resting. Yes, Christ, my hope is arisen. To Galilee he goes before you. Christ indeed from death is risen, our new life obtaining. Have mercy, Victor King, ever reigning. Amen. Alleluia.
From the Holy Gospel according to John.
Glory to you, Lord.
On the first day of the week, Mary of Magdala came to the tomb early in the morning while it was still dark and saw the stone removed from the tomb. So she ran and went to Simon Peter and to the other disciple whom Jesus loved and told them, "They have taken the Lord from the tomb, and we don't know where they put him." So Peter and the other disciple went out and came to the tomb. They both ran, but the other disciple ran faster than Peter and arrived at the tomb first. He bent down and saw the burial cloth there, but did not go in. When Simon Peter arrived after him, he went into the tomb and saw the burial cloth there and the cloth that had covered his head, not with the burial cloths, but rolled up in a separate place. Then the other disciple also went in, the one who had arrived at the tomb first, and he saw and believed, for they did not yet understand the scripture that he had to rise from the dead. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
A very blessed Easter to all of you. It's wonderful to look out and not only see our students, but to see families visiting and with us today, coming together as a community of faith here at Franciscan University, coming together because of the blessing and the gift of the resurrection, the very fabric of our lives. We greet each other today with the words, Christ is risen, alleluia. And then we respond, he is risen indeed, alleluia. So we remember his resurrection today. And those words come so easily off of our tongues, but what a price for those words. What a gift of that reality. This is the very premise on which our faith is built. This is the constant truth that makes the biggest difference in our lives. And we speak and we believe as Christians of the resurrection of Jesus as a concrete event, an event that happened in history and changed everything, an event that demands a response from every person. Will I believe? Will I live in the belief of the resurrection? Something that strikes me is that we're all on a journey of faith. And it's wonderful when we hear the readings themselves to know that the first witnesses, the apostles, the women who came and followed Jesus, all of them were on a journey of faith as well. None of them were different from us in a sense as human beings, a different culture and a different time, but they had to grapple with who Jesus is. They had to grapple with what was happening to them. And what seems to be the constant is that God meets us where we're at and raises us to himself through love. God meets us where we're at and raises us to himself through love. Any response of faith on our part is a gift. It's a gift of God who has first loved us. It was not you who first loved me, he tells us in the first letter of John, but I who first loved you. I who first called you, I who first manifested myself to you. And I think that the evangelist, the writer of the Gospel of John, understood this reality. John chapter 20, of which we hear the first of John chapter 20 today, is actually four carefully constructed scenes of the movement of individuals towards deeper faith in the risen Christ. The first story is what we hear today, the visits to the empty tomb of Mary Magdalene and Simon Peter and the beloved disciple. In the days to come, we will hear the other stories, Jesus appearing to Mary Magdalene, and then we hear of Jesus appearing to the disciples in the upper room, except for Thomas, and then we hear the story at the end of John chapter 20 of Jesus appearing to the disciples and Thomas is with them. And it seems that in all these stories, there's like a deeper invitation. A deeper invitation of the Lord to his disciples that they will come to know and come to believe. He loves them. He responds to them, to their needs. He meets them personally, uniquely. Think of it. Mary Magdalene, the next time she comes after today's gospel, she thinks that Jesus is a gardener. And he says, Mary. And she hears her name and she knows. Thomas, come, touch my wounds. Okay, that's what you want? Okay, that's what you'll have. Touch my wounds. I want you to know me. I want you to know my love. Peter, feed my sheep. Three times, tell me you will feed them. In response to the three times you betrayed me, know of my love. So for Mary Magdalene, for Thomas, for Peter, for all the disciples and for us, he meets us where we are at and invites us closer, invites us to himself. In today's resurrection story, we go to the empty tomb. It says that Mary Magdalene came to the tomb early in the morning when it was still dark. That may have been a geographic reality. I think it was also the reality of her heart. Her heart was still dark with the sorrow, with the anguish of having been with the dead body of Jesus, our Lord, having mourned him, having seen what he went through. She sees the stone removed and believes the body of Jesus has been stolen. She's not yet at a place of belief that he is risen. Does the Lord write her off because of that? No. He takes her where she at, where she's at. He meets her. He gives her another opportunity. As Father Sean said so beautifully, if you were at the vigil last night, second chances. Sometimes even third, fourth, fifth, many chances to come closer, to know him, to love him. Simon Peter and the beloved disciple run to the tomb. Peter had been, if we speak of fight or flight, he had been in flight mode. He had been moving away from Jesus. He had denied him. And yet now he runs towards him. He runs towards him. And the Lord will invite him back into that relationship, back into those depths. The beloved disciple, the disciple with a unique, deep, intimate love of the Lord, the one who had laid his head against the chest of Jesus, runs with Peter. He runs to the tomb. What is he thinking? What is he feeling as he peers in and sees the burial cloths? They enter the tomb. There is much amiss. Why would a body be stolen or moved but unwrapped first of the burial cloths? Why would the headcloth be moved to a separate space? They wrestle with these thoughts. They wonder, what could it be? And there's some inkling at the end of the gospel that at least the beloved disciple starts to believe in some way, but we don't know how much. And it even says that they did not yet understand the scripture that Jesus would rise from the dead. They needed to grow deeper. They needed to be invited further. They were on a journey. Resurrection faith, sisters and brothers, is not simply a moment in time. He may have risen from the dead in a moment, in full power, but we as mere human beings are on a journey of faith that continually needs to be renewed, recommitted to. It's a prevailing reality. It's a reality that shapes every breath of our life, who we are. And then think of Peter to this first reading today from the Acts of the Apostles. He's a man who had been entrusted with so much, a man who betrayed so much, a man who was thoroughly transformed by Jesus. And now he claims to be a witness. He says, he commissioned us to preach to the people and testify that he is the one appointed by God as judge of the living and the dead. To him all the prophets bear witness that everyone who believes in him will receive forgiveness of sins through his name. Everything has changed for Peter. The once so strong leader of the disciples, the one so greatly humbled, has received the Holy Spirit and now cannot but speak of Christ to everyone he meets. Everything has changed because of Jesus' resurrection. From running to the empty tomb and seeing only burial cloths to preaching fearlessly about the Lord, this is resurrection faith. Resurrection faith is the faith that shapes our lives. We live in the reality of the resurrection. It shapes everything we do as people of faith, our purpose. And yet often we might take it for granted, or we might forget the incredible reality before us. I've been thinking about something that maybe you've been thinking about. I have a feeling that I know what you may be doing the afternoon of Monday, April 8th. It's a solar eclipse. I have a feeling that many of us will be, with our glasses on, I hope, looking up at this wonder of nature. And I was thinking about that. It also happens to fall on the Annunciation of the Lord to Mary, which is interesting timing. This natural sign in the sky on a day where we celebrate the supernatural. And it made me think about the sun. I was thinking about St. Francis's beautiful Canticle of the Creatures, where he says, I praise you, Lord, for Sir Brother Sun, so beautiful, so wise, so warm, through whom we have light. But I was thinking of the sun. Of course, if we didn't have the physical sun, We could not exist. We would not have the warmth. We would not have the sustenance as human beings. And yet the Son was made by the true Son, the risen Son. The risen Son, if the risen Son, if the Lord had not risen, we could not be. We could not exist. We could not have hope. Our faith would be in vain, as St. Paul says. Oh, that you would stir up our hearts to remind us of this message, Lord. Oh, that you would remind us today of the great gift of the resurrection, that we only live and move and have our being in the risen Christ. We come to that risen Christ with varying levels of faith. Sometimes our faith is strong, sometimes it's weak, but he's always inviting us into his brilliance. He's always inviting us into his warmth, into his love. Everything changes because Jesus is risen. And I want to close these words today with the words of Monsignor Luigi Gisani in an Easter homily, who reminds us of the power of the resurrection. Monsignor Gisani wrote, "Ever since the day Peter and John ran to the empty tomb and saw him risen and alive in their midst, everything can change. From then on and forever, a person can change, can live anew. The presence of Jesus of Nazareth is like a sap that, from within, mysteriously but certainly refreshes our dryness and makes the impossible possible. What for us is impossible is not impossible for God. So that the slightest hint of a new humanity to someone who looks with a sincere eye and heart becomes visible through the company of those who recognize that he is present, God with us. The slightest hint of a new humanity, like dry and bitter nature becoming fresh and green once more. Everything changes because Jesus Christ is alive for us today, here, now, for eternity. All glory be to him forever. Amen." Dear brothers and sisters, through the Paschal mystery, we have been buried with Christ in baptism so that we may walk with him in newness of life. And so now that our Lenten observance is concluded, let us renew the promises of holy baptism by which we once renounced Satan and his works and promised to serve God in the Holy Catholic Church. And so I ask you, do you renounce Satan? And all his works.
I do.
And all his empty show.
I do.
Do you believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth?
I do.
Do you believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was born of the Virgin Mary, suffered death and was buried, rose again from the dead, and is seated at the right hand of the Father?
I do.
Do you believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and life everlasting?
I do.
And may Almighty God, the Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, who has given us new birth by water and the Holy Spirit, and bestowed on us forgiveness of our sins, keep us by his grace in Christ Jesus our Lord for eternal life.
I saw water flowing from the temple's right hand side. all to whom this water came were saved and shall say, Alleluia, Alleluia, Alleluia. Praise the Lord. From your side, O risen Christ, springs the water of new life by which our sins are washed away. Life has been made new. Alleluia, Alleluia, Alleluia. Praise the Lord. Chosen people, priesthood sing. Holy ones proclaim his deeds. A mighty God has called us out of darkness into light. Alleluia, Alleluia, Alleluia. Praise the Lord. Through the waters weary bore, death's dark shadow is no more. Christ our Savior and our Lord has won the victory.
We now bring our prayers and our petitions before the Lord in trust and confidence.
For the Holy Catholic Church in this Easter season, that the people of God may dwell in the love of the risen Christ as a light before the whole world, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the pro-life movement in our country, that the risen Lord would be a sign for all peoples and bring conversion to the heart of the nation, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the Franciscan University of Steubenville, especially those graduating, that our faithfulness to the life of the church will give great witness to the power of the resurrection of Jesus. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the poor, in this Easter season, that through the mercy of God, they may receive all they need and come to know Christ's true love for them. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the sick and suffering in our community, that the Lord Jesus grant them a renewal in hope and healing in his love. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all the faithfully departed, who has risen from the dead, they may enter into the fullness of his eternal glory. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all the intentions that we hold in the silence of our hearts. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. Risen Lord, we thank you for your very life that you give us. Please receive the prayers we have offered out loud and those in our hearts. And we ask this in your name, Jesus Christ, our Lord.
Thank you.
Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and all his holy church.
Exultant with paschal gladness, O Lord, we offer the sacrifice by which your church is wondrously reborn and nourished through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, at all times to acclaim you, O Lord, but on this day above all, to laud you yet more gloriously, when Christ our Passover has been sacrificed. For he is the true Lamb who has taken away the sins of the world. By dying he has destroyed our death, and by rising restored our life. Therefore, overcome with paschal joy, every land, every people, exult in your praise, and even the heavenly powers with the angelic hosts sing together the unending hymn of your glory as they acclaim. To you, therefore, most merciful Father, we make humble prayer and petition through Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord, that you accept and bless these gifts, these offerings, these holy and unblemished sacrifices, which we offer you firstly for your holy Catholic Church. Be pleased to grant her peace, to guard, unite, and govern her throughout the whole world. Together with your servant Francis, our Pope, and Paul, our Bishop, and all those who, holding to the truth, hand on the Catholic and Apostolic faith.
Remember, Lord, your servants for whom we now pray. And all those gathered here whose faith and devotion are known to you, for them we offer you the sacrifice of praise or they offered for themselves. and all who are dear to them, for the redemption of their souls in hope of health and well-being, and paying their homage to you, the eternal God, living and true.
Celebrating the most sacred day of the resurrection of our Lord Jesus Christ in the flesh, and in communion with those whose memory we venerate, especially the glorious ever-Virgin Mary, Mother of our God and Lord Jesus Christ, and Blessed Joseph, her spouse, your blessed apostles and martyrs, Peter and Paul, Andrew, James, John, Thomas, James, Philip, Bartholomew, Matthew, Simon, and Jude, Linus, Cletus, Clement, Sixtus, Cornelius, Cyprian, Lawrence, Chrysogonus, John and Paul, Cosmas and Damian, and all your saints. We ask that through their merits and prayers and all things we may be defended by your protecting help.
Therefore, Lord, we pray, graciously accept this oblation of our service, that of your whole family, which we make to you also for those to whom you have been pleased to give the new birth of water and the Holy Spirit, granting them forgiveness of all their sins. Order our days in your peace, and command that we be delivered from eternal damnation and counted among the flock of those you have chosen. Be pleased, O God, we pray, to bless, acknowledge, and approve this offering in every respect. Make it spiritual and acceptable, so that it may become for us the body and blood of your most beloved Son, our Lord Jesus Christ. On the day before he was to suffer, he took bread in his holy and venerable hands, and with eyes raised to heaven, to you, O God, his almighty Father, giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice. He took this precious chalice in his holy and venerable hands. And once more giving you thanks, he said the blessing and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
Savior of the world, for by your cross and resurrection, you have set us free. You have set us free.
Therefore, O Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the Blessed Passion, the resurrection from the dead, and the glorious ascension into heaven of Christ, your Son, our Lord, we, your servants and your holy people, offer to your glorious majesty, from the gifts that you have given us, this pure victim, this holy victim, this spotless victim, the holy bread of eternal life and the chalice of everlasting salvation. Be pleased to look upon these offerings with a serene and kindly countenance, and to accept them as once you were pleased to accept the gifts of your servant Abel the just, the sacrifice of Abraham, our father in faith, and the offering of your high priest Melchizedek, a holy sacrifice, a spotless victim. In humble prayer, we ask you, Almighty God, command that these gifts be borne by the hands of your holy angel to your altar on high in the sight of your divine majesty, so that all of us who through this participation at the altar receive the most holy body and blood of your Son may be filled with every grace and heavenly blessing.
Remember also, Lord, your servants who have gone before us with a sign of faith and rest in the sleep of peace. Grant them, O Lord, we pray, and all who sleep in Christ, a place of refreshment, light, and peace.
To us also, your servants, who dost hear us, hope in your abundant mercies, graciously grant some share and fellowship with your holy apostles and martyrs, with John the Baptist, Stephen, Matthias, Barnabas, Ignatius, Alexander, Marcellinus, Peter, Felicity, Perpetua, Argata, Loxi, Agnes, Cecilia, Anastasia, and all your saints. Admit us, we beseech you, into their company, not weighing our merits, but granting us your pardon, through Christ our Lord.
Through whom you continue to make all these good things, O Lord. You sanctify them, fill them with life, bless them, and bestow them upon us. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. Amen. The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace.
Stays, qui tollis peccata mundi, miserere nobis,
miserere nobis.
Agnus Deus, qui tollis peccata mundi.
Thank you.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
It was finished on that day. Death was beaten, all darkness was slain. All his passion poured out like the rain upon the earth. 3 days buried, they came to mourn. The stone was rolled away, the veil was torn. For he had risen, he is the King of all the earth. Alleluia, he has conquered death. Death. has conquered death. We cry, holy, he reigns in all the earth. Hallelujah, he has conquered death and he reigns. He reigns and he reigns. Mercy spoke for me, mercy spoke for me. It was on Golgotha's tree, his death brought liberty, his death brought liberty, his death brought liberty. May I never boast in anything except the cross of Jesus Christ. May I not forget the blood he shed. It is by his death I am alive, because of Christ I am alive. What a humble sacrifice, love that washed me clean, love that washed me clean, love that washed me clean. What a blessed mystery, his punishment my peace, his punishment my peace, his punishment my peace. May I never boast in anything except the cross of Jesus Christ. May I not forget the blood he shed. It is by his death I am alive, because of Christ I am alive, because of Christ I am alive. Its grip on me. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Jesus rose in victory. He's alive, alive in me. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Praise the one who set me free. Death has lost its grip on me. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Jesus rose in victory. He's alive, alive in me. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Praise the one who set me free. Death has lost its grip on me. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Jesus rose in victory. He's alive, alive in me. May I never lived the cross of Jesus Christ. May I not forget the blood he shed. It is by his death I am alive. Because of Christ I am alive. Because of Christ I am
Let us pray. Look upon your church, O God, with unfailing love and favor, so that, renewed by the Paschal mysteries, she may come to the glory of the resurrection, through Christ our Lord. Just want to take a moment to again welcome those who are guests who are here with us, and those who are not guests. It's good to worship together, be together today. Also, just want to take a moment to thank our chapel ministries team, our servers, our readers, all who are in the background, who have worked so hard throughout this Triduum and Easter, and we're just very grateful. And our music ministry, and many people, even people doing the sound behind you, people doing things that we don't even realize. Thank you for adding to the liturgy, giving glory to God. And I know on behalf of the friars, I just want to wish you and your families a very blessed Easter. It's a season. We begin a season of grace. And so may the Lord bless you and your families in this season. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Bow down for the blessing. May Almighty God bless you through today's Easter solemnity, and in his compassion defend you from every assault of sin. Amen. And may he who restores you to eternal life in the resurrection of his only begotten endow you with the prize of immortality. Now that the days of the Lord's Passion have drawn to a close, may you who celebrate the gladness of the Paschal Feast come with Christ's help and exulting in spirit to those feasts that are celebrated in eternal joy.
Amen.
And may the blessing of Almighty God, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit come down on you and remain with you forever.
Amen.
Go in peace. Alleluia. Alleluia.
Thanks be to God. Alleluia.
Sing to Jesus. God.